at this MR2. I got this from a gentleman in South Carolina a few weeks ago. He gave me a really good deal. Thank you, Nathan. And this car is going to be a perfect donor to do the Tesla project. It has a few missing parts, which is fine. But overall, it's right where we need it for what we're going to be doing here. First off the bat, I stripped out a bunch of the manual transmission stuff, like the clutch master and slave cylinders, the hard line, hydraulic hard line, the shifter cables, shifter itself, clutch pedal, that kind of stuff. And it doesn't have a motor in it right now either, so we're ready to pretty much test fit. But first, what I want to do is I want to take it over to Brian's at Excess Motor Works, and I want to weigh this thing without the motor in it, without the fuel tank in it, and kind of we'll get a baseline. We'll weigh this, and then we'll weigh the Tesla motor, and we'll get a baseline for where we're gonna be, and then how much battery weight we could add on this thing to kind of go at the same equal weight as a regular MR2, turbo MR2, I should say, with a full tank of fuel. So the other thing is we'll probably end up spraying most of this car white just to make it easier for us to 3D scan the thing. I don't even know where else to go, because right now, I mean, I could dive into it, pull it all apart, and I really don't want to. I want to do it one step at a time. I'm really, really excited. I want to, like, do a whole wide-body kit on this thing and everything, but I'm trying to, like, get myself under control, say one thing at a time. So first is going to be weighing and getting that motor down under there, kind of getting positions. Then we're going to scan it and scan the motor, and then we're going to kind of go in the computer, design some stuff. We'll work with Eric Hux at Hux Racing on the motor cradle mount that we're going to use for this. And I do believe once we're done, we're planning on making this a kit too. Eric will be selling direct bolt-in mounts for the Tesla motor. And I'm trying to think what else. We'll probably just put a roll bar in it or a cage in it at some point, because it's going to be a straight race car, pretty much. So I'm definitely going to do a lot to this car, and I'm going to document everything, but we're going to take it one step at a time, and I hope that you guys like it. If you have any ideas, or if you see me doing something wrong, feel free to message me or put it in the comments. I'm open to ideas and different concepts, and love MR2s and all you guys that own them as well. So we're trying to do something outside the box. I've tried to do that with my personal car over the years, tried to do different things, and this one's got my energy in it right now, man. I haven't been this excited about a project in a very long time. So let's cut to it. Okay, recording.
You're recording?
Yes.
Okay. Hi, this is a scale, and this is a Tesla motor. And today, we're going to be weighing the Tesla motor.
Yes, pretty much.
So that was good. That was a good explanation.
That's a good one. So this scale, I don't know if we'll be able to see it in the video.
Yeah, you can.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So right now it's zeroed out. I have it only one connected. These are Cameron scales, so thank Cameron for letting us use these. And so zeroed out now. We'll try to get this Tesla motor flipped over onto the scale without killing ourselves here, and we'll get a weight on it. There we go. Okay, so we get that on, and then this is actually Brian's and his partner's motor that he's letting us use to do these tests. They've taken the diff out because they ordered a Quaife limited slip differential put in, so we'll just put the stock one just on there so we get the right weight. Okay, so now it's going down. 289 pounds. So looking like 288. show you on the screen. If you can see that. Here's another little piece of the puzzle. The way I want to mount this motor, I want to keep it mid-engine, just like the MR2 is originally. I don't want the electric motor behind the axle, I want it in front of the axle. So to do that, you can spin the motor around, or you can flip it over. I am going to spin the motor around. So to spin the motor around, you have to change the pump, the oil pump that's in the differential. And this came from a company. I'll get you guys the name. I'll put it in the description. And it's a nice billet CNC part, aluminum. And basically just all what you do is spin the motor in reverse and still will oil the gear, the rear diff. So look for that.